Well, actually, we've recovered amazingly well since our low in April. And really, the biggest story is our Echo Park stores, which we have 10 locations across the country. And we have recovered now above our pre-COVID levels. We're actually tracking for an all-time record June in those stores, both in volume and profit. You know, we did about $1.2 billion at our Echo Park stores in 2019. And we have a plan, actually, we're going to be rolling out here pretty soon to talk about increasing that in short order to about $10 billion in revenue just with our Echo Park stores and rolling those out into additional locations across the country.
And Echo Park is an interesting concept, as I understand it. It's used cars, but it is low mileage, 4 years or younger, never been in an accident. And do you use a fixed price approach there, or is it the typical sort of negotiate your best deal?
No, we do. It's what we call nearly new, and they're all fixed pricing. And we are actually, our prices are very aggressive, and our customers, that's one of the reasons why our customers drive in from all over, as much as, you know, from, we've had people come in from Alaska actually to buy cars from Echo Park. But that's why our Echo Park store, on average, the 10 stores do about 10 times the volume of a traditional pre-owned or franchise dealer store as far as our number of units per store.
When you say franchise dealers, how does that work? I'm just curious, and we don't need to linger on it. Do those franchises carry either the Echo Park or the Sonic name, or is it Joe Williams Ford, but you are the owner of that franchise from the Ford company? How does it work?
Yeah, our franchise stores have different names all over the country, from California to Florida, while our Echo Park stores are standalone pre-owned stores with the Echo Park name only. And mm-hmm. And so really a phenomenon to see, whereas a traditional franchise dealer might sell 50 or 60 pre-owned cars a month in a regular franchise store, whereas an Echo Park store, we sell on average 600. We have one of our stores sells about 1,300 per month. And during COVID, during the pandemic, the Echo Park stores were the stores that were the most resilient during the whole pandemic. So that's really, from an investor standpoint, that's really what I think is most interesting, is to see that growth and taking what now is a combined $10.5 billion company to now we're going to show a path to getting to $20 billion in total revenue, which, again, from an investor standpoint, we think that's what is most important.
David, let's talk about, again, some of the near-term trends. Our Phil Lebeau this morning was tweeting about a dealer who was contemplating shutting down over July 4th. This is a new car dealer because demand was so strong and inventory was so light. Does that resonate, or is that, you think, unique to a few markets? This is a Ford dealer in the Northeast and a few types of cars.
Well, no, in our new vehicle franchise stores, some of the most popular models, we have a lighter day supply of those, but the shopper out there, they know because they can look, online and see what is out there, and they can see that there's not a big day supply. So then our gross profit, for those new vehicles is higher than it usually would be. But as the manufacturers ramp back up, we think it's only a 2 or 3 month delay from getting back to our pre-COVID day supply levels. But as far as Echo Park goes, we've been ramping back up and buying inventory, pre-owned inventory through this whole thing. And so that's why we're back up, far above our pre-COVID levels. So because we had an all-time record 2019, and January and February were tracking to be all-time records. And then we hit this COVID. So we've been very excited about how quickly it's bounced back.